Hello students, it is class 9. Today just we have to study about Golgi apparatus. So just you are seeing that I have drawn a rough diagram of Golgi apparatus, and just we will discuss about Golgi apparatus. You should know Golgi apparatus was discovered by the Camillo Golgi in the nerve cell of barn owl. Okay. This Golgi apparatus is present in all the type of eukaryotic cells except mature RBC and sperm of the mammal. Okay, it is absent in all the prokaryotic cells like bacteria, blue green algae, etc. Okay, now we will see about the structure of Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus is made of cisternae, vesicles, and vacuoles. Okay, you are seeing here in Golgi apparatus many flat tube-like structures are present, which are parallelly arranged from one another, and these flat tube-like structures are called cisternae. So we are seeing here Golgi apparatus is made up of many cisternae, vesicles, and vacuoles. What are cisternae? They are the many flat tubular structures which are present parallel to one another. Okay. Now you should know Golgi apparatus is made of a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It is a membranous structure which is made from a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. Now you can see Golgi apparatus has two poles, in which one is called cis or forming phase, whereas other is called trans or maturing phase. Means we can say Golgi apparatus has two phases, in which one is called cis or forming phase, whereas other is called trans or maturing phase. You should know cis phase receives the secretory material from the smooth endoplasmic reticulum in the form of secretory vesicles or transporting vesicles, we can say. Okay, once again listen, the cis phase of the Golgi apparatus receives secretory material from the smooth endoplasmic reticulum through the transporting vesicles, and these secretory materials are processed in the Golgi apparatus, and through, or you can say from, the trans or maturing phase, these secretory vesicles are budded off in the form of large vesicles or vacuoles. Okay. Now we will see about the function of the Golgi apparatus. What are the functions of Golgi apparatus? Listen first. It acts as a main secretory cell organelles of the cell. First function. Second function, it helps in the restoration, transformation, and packaging of the secretory substances which are synthesized by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum or other cell organelles. Next, it helps in the formation of lysosome and peroxisome. Next, it helps in the formation of cell plate in plant cell during cell division. Next point, sometimes it helps in the formation of complex sugar from the simple sugar. So these are the various functions performed by the Golgi apparatus. Once again, just I am going to say about the function of Golgi apparatus. First, it acts as a main secretory cell organelle of the cell. Second, it helps in the process of restoration, transformation, and packaging of substances synthesized by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum or other cell organelles. Second, next function, it helps in the formation of lysosome and peroxisome. Next point, it helps in the formation of cell plate in plant cell during the process of cell division. Next point, sometimes it helps in the formation of complex sugar from the simple sugar. Okay, so these are the different function of Golgi apparatus. So just I'm going to write here, this is the rough diagram of Golgi apparatus. Okay. This Golgi apparatus is also known as Golgi complex or Golgi body. Okay. So today, besides Golgi apparatus, we have to discuss about the different types of solution. So I'm going to write on the board. Okay, today just we will discuss about three types of solution, in which one is called hypertonic solution, second is called hypotonic solution, and third is called isotonic solution. Okay, so today just we have to discuss about three types of solution: hypertonic, hypotonic, and isotonic solution. Okay, one by one just we'll discuss. So just I'm going to write about hypertonic solution first of all. What is hypertonic solution? You should know. A solution in itself can't be hypertonic, hypotonic, isotonic. When we compare two solutions, then we can say one solution is hypertonic or isotonic than the other solution. Okay? So, just we'll discuss about hypertonic solution. What is hypertonic solution? Suppose that you have a solution in a container in which you have kept a cell, plant cell or animal cell. Okay? So, now just we have to define hypertonic solution. Listen carefully. A medium surrounding the cell, suppose that it is a cell it is. Okay, and this is the solution, means hypertonic solution. So how will you define? Listen, a medium surrounding the cell having high concentration of solute and low concentration of solvent in comparison to the solution present inside the cell is called hypertonic solution. Means in hypertonic solution, more solute and less solvent are present. Okay? In hypertonic solution, hyper means more and hypo means less. So what is more? Solute. Okay? So we can say, and we can define the hypertonic solution in this way: a solution surrounding the cell or a medium surrounding the cell having high concentration of solute or low concentration of solvent is called hypertonic solution. Now listen, if we keep a cell in a hypertonic solution, then what will happen? You know, in a hypertonic solution, less solvent is present in comparison to the solution present inside the cell. Means we can say inside the cell the solution which is present having more solvent. And you know, solvent always moves from high concentration to low concentration, since inside the cell the concentration of solvent is more in comparison to the hypertonic solution. So what will happen? The solution, means the solvent which is present inside the solution of the cell, comes out or diffuses out through the process of exosmosis. As a result, what will happen? Cell will shrink. And you know, if shrinking takes place in plant cell, then it will be called plasmolyzed cell. But if shrinking takes place in animal cell, then it is called crenated animal cell. Once again, listen. If exosmosis takes place in plant cell, then shrinking will take place, and such type of shrunken plant cell will be called plasmolyzed plant cell. Whereas if this shrinking takes place in animal cell, then such type of shrunken animal cell will be called crenated animal cell. Okay. Now we will discuss about hypotonic solution. So I am going to erase it and we will discuss about hypotonic solution. What is the meaning of hypo? Hypo means less. What is less? Solute. Suppose that you have a container having a solution in it and you have kept a cell in that solution. Suppose that it is your cell and this is hypotonic solution. Hypotonic solution. In hypotonic solution, less solute, okay, and more solvent are present. Whereas the solution which is present inside the cell having more solvent and less solute is present. Now just we have to compare, but besides comparing, just we have to discuss about the hypotonic solution. What is hypotonic solution? A medium surrounding the cell having less concentration of solute and more concentration of solvent in comparison to the solution present in the cell called hypotonic solution. Okay, now we will discuss what will happen if you keep a plant cell in a hypotonic solution and what will happen if you keep an animal cell in a hypotonic solution. Listen, if you keep an animal cell in a hypotonic solution, then you know, since in a hypotonic solution, more solvent is present in comparison to the solution present in the cell, and you should know, solvent always moves from high concentration to low concentration. As a result, the solvent which is present in the hypotonic solution in large amount will diffuse inside the cell by the process called endosmosis. And finally, animal cell bursts. Okay. But if you keep plant cell in a hypotonic solution, then plant cells do not burst due to the presence of cell wall. And such type of plant cell will swell up. And such type of swell, or we can say such type of swell plant cell is called turgid. Okay. And the swelling produces a special type of pressure on the cell wall called turgid pressure, which maintains the entry of the water to the cell to a certain limit. Okay, so this is your hypotonic solution. And at last, just I'm going to discuss about isotonic solution. What is isotonic solution? A medium around the cell having same concentration or equal concentration of solute and solvent in comparison to the solution present in the cell called isotonic solution. Okay, so in this way, this chapter, means cell chapter, just I have completed, and from next day just we will discuss about tissue. Okay, thank you. Yeah.